So, Nick, for the benefit of the live stream, can you just give people a little context on who you are, what you're up to, what you're passionate about?
Sure. My name is Nick Grossman. I represent a couple of organizations working in the civic technology space, Open Plans, Civic Commons, and Code for America. We're all nonprofits that are helping to spur innovation in civic technology, help governments do tech better, help citizens use tech better, and make cities better places to live.
Awesome. And I mean, I know those organizations very well. They're probably three of my favorite in the world. Can you give the live stream a quick sense of what Code for America is and how it relates to smarter cities and also civic commons? Because most folks probably don't know as much about them, maybe.
Sure. So Code for America is basically a Teach for America for software developers that sends young, talented programmers to go work in cities for a year-long fellowship and develop applications that promote transparency and participation and civic engagement. And Civic Commons is a new initiative that we just started that's basically a repository for the code and knowledge and techniques and practices that are developed sort of across the civic tech landscape. We want to communicate the lessons learned from the cities that are innovating and doing experiments. We want to create a place for shared code. So if cities are developing applications from sort of managing their parking ticket systems all the way to managing how they do city planning and beyond, there's a lot of software that's being developed. There are a lot of techniques that are being developed. There are a lot of sort of recipes for putting together civic tech. Mm-hmm. And our job at Civic Commons is to sort of extract the lessons and help sort of make matches among cities that are potentially developing similar tools so that they can benefit from each other's experience and development, reduce their costs, and ultimately produce more effective technology.
So certainly Open Plans has been an innovator in this space for years, right? I think you've probably been with Open Plans for 5 or 6 years now.
Yep.
How has your role and what the organization's role changed in that period? Because I know there's been dramatic progress in a good way in this space over that time.
Yeah, it's been a fascinating time over the past 5 or 6 years to be involved in the civic technology and media space. I've had the privilege of sort of participating in some of that and watching a lot of it. Open Plans is a nonprofit organization. It's been around for about 10 years, and we're an incubator of sorts for civic technology and media projects. We have a particular interest in urban planning and transportation and then the technology and media forces that play on that. And we develop sort of websites that help connect people with the civic issues in their neighborhood. And we also have sort of developed new actual technology projects. And our work in the open government and civic tech space over the last 3 years in particular has coincided with a really gigantic explosion, popular explosion in people having apps on their phones that sort of connect them to their cities, to cities putting on things like app contests, to publishing data sets. There's been this real confluence of interest across the country and across the world in civic tech land, and we've had the sort of fortunate position to be part of that and sort of help a variety of efforts get traction to support the civic technology landscape over the course of that.
So you've witnessed and participated in this groundswell over the past few years. Is there another one coming? And if so, how is it different? What is that groundswell going to be composed of?
Great question. There's no question that there's another groundswell coming. This is really just the beginning of the rising of the wave, or the tip of the iceberg, or pick your metaphor. I mean, the just from a civic commons perspective, the amount of interest that we're getting on behalf on the part of city governments and government technologists on how do we do this? How do we implement a program like this? How should we be rethinking our technology? Like, the early successes and the early examples that have been put forward in the past couple of years are really just whetting the appetite of everybody. And so I think it's going to be huge. I think people are getting more comfortable with technology. They're getting more literate with data and information, and we're starting to think about sort of civic technology and civic information as something that's relevant to them in their lives. And we're seeing governments and other civic institutions everywhere piquing their interest in this. And so there's no question that big things are going to come. I can't tell you exactly what's going to happen, but there's no question that the sort of space and the community of people that are working on this is growing at a furious rate. And we'll hopefully see lots of things fail and also lots of things succeed so that we can learn from both and continue to build our sort of shared understanding of how to do this and keep building things that make cities work better.
So where do we watch you fail or succeed on the web?
You can follow me at Nick Grossman on Twitter, also openplans.org, civiccommons.org. codeforamerica.org are all good places. And if you're interested in me personally, you can look me up at nickgrossman.info.
Wonderful. Thanks so much, Nick.
Thanks, Peter.
Take care.